Hello everybody, welcome back. We are going to take a quick look at the Anvil Terrapin, one of the new vessels of Star Citizen 3.1 that was made available earlier today on the PTU. I have to admit that the Terrapin is one of my favorite ships in Star Citizen and I was really looking forward for the opportunity to fly with it and test it. The Terrapin is a scanning exploration vessel with a focus on discovering points of interest or even monitoring a specific area for any kind of activity. Its primary role is to discover valuable locations or secrets so you can sell this info for a good profit. It is not a vessel that you want to use for transferring goods or loot around, since its cargo capacity is officially zero. Despite that, you can place manually cargo crates or items in its interior if the need arises, something that makes the Terrapin a quite decent option for Star Citizen 3.1 for anyone traveling around completing missions and scavenging crates. To achieve its mission and fulfill its role, the Terrapin can carry a crew of 2 persons, a pilot and a scanner operator. Its interior is practically divided in 2 areas, the cockpit and the support station where the scan operator sits. At the back of the ship, we can also find a small crew quarters area with a bed and everything essential for the crew to survive. A very interesting characteristic of this vessel is the ease of reaching and replacing components since they are located inside. The gameplay of the Terrapin will be to approach an area of interest, disable most of its components and wait patiently to discover, listen for what the owner is looking for, whether that is a point of interest or enemy activity. The design of the ship gives emphasis to protection and this is why it looks like a turtle. The Terrapin is heavily armored and able to take a beating if discovered. Another special characteristic of this ship is that it can open its armor plates to vent heat out, an essential feature for anyone planning to spend hours inside the Terrapin, silent, waiting to discover the right info. With a focus on defense and heavy armor, the Terrapin is logical not to be the most agile or fast spaceship. Its SEM speed can go up to 210 meters per second and its afterburner speed up to 1205 meters per second. Something we need to mention is that it has a slow acceleration which makes the heavy armor even more important. As for shield defenses, it comes with a medium shield generator. The Terrapin does not have an offensive focus, hence it comes equipped with only a turret with 2 sides 2 M4A laser cannons. These are there mainly for doing some damage and keeping opponents at bay rather than destroying enemies. Your best bet in case of an emergency will be to try and escape, hoping that your defenses will last long enough to reach your maximum afterburner speed. Even then, it would be hard to escape a serious group of pursuers. This is why areas like asteroid belts where you can hide and use the asteroids to escape should be your number one destination, your number one priority when using the Terrapin. The vessel also comes with a size 2 utility mount where its scanner, its most essential tool, is equipped. There is only one entry and exit to the ship and that is from the side ramp. Hard to escape if things start going south. In the cockpit we can find 8 screens that give to the pilot a greater look at his components and ship status and of course a 3D radar. The visibility is quite bad, but the role of the Terrapin is not sightseeing. Its role is to sit idle, silent, while the scanner operator is doing his job, listening for the right info and leave the area hopefully undetected. This was the Terrapin, a scanning exploration vessel with a very interesting role to play in the verse. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more. I am Squid of Love and I will see you around the verse. Bye bye.